So let's start with our prayer to 1 minute prayer for Lord Sai.
Sri Sai Nathaya Namah Namah Sri Sachidanandaya Namah Namah Sri Mangalamurade Namah Namah.
So you are going to the world, to a different world. The school life was 14 years of school life was a controlled, fully controlled stage where many things were given to you as input from the various schools that you studied, and your parents also inculcated in you the family values. And with the maturity that, because of age, you got in the 3 years of graduation, that's the next phase of life where you learned how you can equate yourself into various odds and situations, how cohesively you can stay in a society, how you can contribute to the society, and probably try to find out the purpose for which you are born. There are only two objectives of every individual who is born in this world. There are only two objectives of every individual who is born in this world. First objective is to be happy. Everything that you do in life, everything that you have done till date in life, and everything that you will be doing henceforth till the last breath you have, is something to do to make you happy. So always you try to do something thinking that this will make me happy. But at times your perception happiness misleads you to do certain wrong things. And because of the corrective measure that is in you, the intellect that God has given to you, you try to correct yourself and research your ways and methods to find out again the newer ways of finding happiness. So this is a fundamental thing which every individual is working towards happiness. Somebody gets happy if gets tons of money. Somebody gets happy if driving a big car. Somebody gets happy if the bank balance is few crores. Somebody is happy if he or she marries the person that he or she wants, or the dream job that one gets. So everything that you do is toward good marks in your exams. So everything leads towards happiness. The next important thing which many fail to recognize, which again leads to happiness, is finding out why you are born. Every individual sitting here is born for a particular purpose. God has not brought you into this world by mistake. It said you get 1 lakh lives before you get a human life. Because human life is the only life where God has given you consciousness to find out what is right and wrong. Whatever is right for you may not be right for others. Mostly it is sin. Whatever is right for you is wrong for somebody else. Like example, suppose you become topper of the university, it is right for you. But that person who becomes second, it was wrong for him because he wanted to be the first. Similarly, suppose you are doing a business and flourishing, and somebody doing the same business is not flourishing, so it is right for you, but wrong for him. So it is very situational. But at every point of time, try to see that knowingly you do not cause harm to others. So that's why you need to quickly find out why you are born. So if you try to find out why you are born, because why I'm telling you this, if you see everybody's career life, whatever you're thinking now, 10 years hence, you'll not be doing that. Everybody's career path changes. Like for me, I have seen a graph. I was trying to plot a graph. So every 7 years, my life takes a turning point and I do something else. 1985, I become a chartered accountant and practiced CA in a typical form. 1992, I restructured the CA firm and created my own firm. And at the same time, I created a BPO. 1999, I created a bigger firm called SRB, and again created the first software technology park. 2007, started doing science transfer school. 2014, I started building Sai Angan. So every 7 years I have seen my life has taken a turning point and something else. So everybody's life you'll find there is a turning point. When I was in plus two, I wanted to be engineer. I got into IIT, I got into NIT, I joined commerce. After commerce, I thought, I'll do practice. Then I become an entrepreneur or entrepreneur. So life takes various changes. So what is most important for you is, you have to keep yourself equipped whenever any opportunity comes, because God will give you opportunities. So whenever an opportunity comes, you are able to face that opportunity and take it forward. And that's what is education. Education is not acquiring information or acquiring knowledge. Education is application of information and application of knowledge. So if educated person means how is your behavior, not how much mark you kept. It's not 98%, 99% doesn't mean that you're educated. You have got some marks. That's because of the situation there. Education means what is your behavior, how you're talking, what's your style, how you're behaving with your seniors, how you're handling a situation, how in a critical method, how you're finding out solutions to that. That's proper education. Like one teacher, he saw a 500 rupee new note, you know, this new RBI notes have started. So he said to the students, if I give to you, how many of you will take? So everybody raised hand, I will take this 500 rupee. Then he crumpled that 500 rupee note and said, now who will take that? Again, everybody raised hand. Then he put that crumpled note on the floor and started, you know, crushing it again, the shoes, and spitting on it. Then he took it and tell, now who will take it? Everybody raised their hand. Yes, we want to take it. Then he asked, you know, why you want to take it? You know, I have made it as dirty as possible. So why you want to take it? So the student said that we want to take it because whatever amount you try to crush it, the intrinsic value of that 500 rupees for me going to the market and getting something doesn't change. So that's what you are. So whatever crushing the society does, your intrinsic value should not change. You should be what you are, like the 500 rupee note. So that's what, you know, your college life, and that's what you should come up in life. I'll give you one more instance. Once Gautama Buddha, a student like you, went to Gautama Buddha with his closed fist and said, there is a butterfly inside. Gautama Buddha, everybody says that you are very intelligent and you can tell. So can you tell whether the butterfly inside is live or dead? Thinking that if Buddha says that it is live, I'll crush it dead and show that it's dead. And if Buddha says that it's dead, I'll just fly it off and say it's alive. So anyway, I'll prove Buddha wrong. So he asked, you know, there is a butterfly in my hand. So can you tell me whether it's alive or dead? Buddha said, the life of the butterfly is whatever you want to be. So if you want to be alive, then a butterfly will be alive. If you want to be dead, the butterfly will be dead. The boy was astonished. Because what Buddha said to the boy is, what you will become in life is in your own hand. Nobody else can decide. Whether you will be a good person, whether you will be a bad person, depends on your own hands, on your own deeds. It's not God will bless to be a good person or God will bless you to be a bad person. It is you who will decide, you know, whether you are good or bad. So why I told you these two instances? I told you these two instances because what you will become in life will depend how you are or how you will be after leaving this institution. So I will not give a very long lecture today. I decided that I will come and listen to all of you and, you know, see some of your acts. But I will wish all of you a very, very bright future, all for the ensuing exams. And please remember that whatever you do in life, you will always be our proud SICCians. Clap for yourself. So always remember this sentence, you know, that either be the best or different from the rest. So choice will always be yours.